Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to my world of fear. Fear which is all around us day by day, in all the nooks and crannies of our lives. Fear of the past, the future, the known and unknown. Laura was a woman who lived surrounded by fear and whose ending no one knows. It is from her diary, a diary that came into my possession not long ago, that I am able to bring you her story today. The story of his last card. Her diary begins, "It was our first Christmas together under our own roof, so we hung lights at the window in the hall and arranged Christmas cards on ribbons round the lounge.
Charles said he hadn't done such things since he was a boy, and it was a relief for a while to see him distracted.
Oh, yes.
Here we are. Last one.
Yes. What's this?
Well, it's a Christmas card, isn't it?
Laura, this is a river scene.
Is it? I didn't know.
It hasn't even got snow on it.
Does it matter?
What do you mean, does it matter? What do you think I have been doing all afternoon?
Yes, I know,
but... Look over the mantelpiece, what do you see?
Christmas cards,
but... not just Christmas cards, nativities. They are all nativities. And there, on the hall wall, birds and animals, you see? Robins, polar bears, penguins.
I can't see that it's that important,
Charles.
If you're
going to do an orderly job, then you might as well make it completely orderly, Laura. Otherwise, what's the point?
All right, calm down.
I mean, these are supposed to be arranged in a square. Look at it. 15 humorous ones and a... A river scene. What on earth? Oh, Laura.
What is it?
I am so sorry.
Why? What's the matter?
Not just a river scene. The embankment. It's from you, isn't it?
Me?
With the park bench and everything. Where we met.
Oh, so it is.
Isn't it from you?
No, it's not mine.
What?
I've never seen it before.
Well, then who is it from?
It's not signed.
Well, what does it say?
Remember? Remember.
Hmm? Is that all?
Yes.
Well, how ridiculous. Remember what?
I don't know.
What sort of a stupid game is this supposed
They've only forgotten to put their name.
Yes, but a park bench on the embankment.
It's a coincidence.
That's
it must be.
Faultless. I mean, that's what it is. It makes me sick, that kind of snapness in people. It's all very well for them.
It's a silly card, that's all.
Laura.
Don't let it get to you.
It's not getting to me.
It is, Charles. Now, look, come on. Sit down.
No.
Sit down and rest. Come, darling. There. It's not worth losing your temper over a silly card.
Yes, but who could have seen
it? Anyone could have done it. It doesn't mean anything.
It must mean something.
Charles, you mustn't start thinking like this again.
What do you mean? Thinking like what?
No one intends you any harm, you know. They like you. People like you. And I like you most of all.
I am sorry, Laura.
Let's put the card away and forget about it, shall we? Remember. Remember. And I did remember. That familiar place where I used to take my lunch. And a name. A name I've been trying so hard to forget. After the weekend, the snow came, catching London unprepared, as it always does. I was delayed at the office, so Richard, one of the clerks, gave me a lift home. An awkward journey. Poor Richard puffing at his pipe and struggling so hard to know what to say. And my mind fixed on other things.
The snow's getting worse. Has your husband found anything yet?
He's got two applications in at the moment.
Oh, that sounds hopeful.
I don't think either is quite right, actually.
I'm sorry.
Still, keeps himself busy. Makes a point of getting out of the house every day.
Really?
He can't stand being cooped up. You understand? If you pull up by that tree.
Oh.
You see?
Here?
Yes. Oh, thanks very much. Thanks very much.
Is anything the matter?
No, it's all right.
You can get into the house?
Yes. It's just that I'm probably being silly, but I think it's being watched.
Watched?
You see that hedge on the corner?
Yes.
This morning I thought I saw someone standing there. Just loitering, you know.
A man?
Yes, and he was there yesterday evening, too.
Oh. Well, there doesn't seem to be anybody there now.
No, it seems... seems all right now. I probably just imagined it.
Do you want to wait here till your husband...
No. I'll be okay.
Look, my sister doesn't expect me home until 7. I could, well, you know, make sure you're...
No, that's sweet of you, Richard, but I've taken up too much of your time already.
I don't mind, honestly. Let me see you to your door, at least.
Well, if you're sure. There was no sign of him when Richard dropped me off. But he had been there. A figure fading in and out of the shadows of lamplight. I peered into the street from behind curtains. But I said nothing to Charles the following morning.
This is a bit late, isn't it?
What is?
The post. When you just come.
It's Christmas. It comes at all hours of the day now.
Yeah. Two for you. One's from Chester, so I expect it'll be Watson.
Alex's mother. Oh, yes, it is. How sweet of her.
Yes.
She never forgets.
Never.
Don't mind, do you?
Well, I sometimes wonder what she's clinging to.
What do you mean, clinging to?
Well, you haven't seen her for years.
She was my mother-in-law, Charles. And she had no one else to turn to after Alex's accident. I was family.
But I am your husband now.
Of course you are.
Oh, I don't know. I find it all a bit morbid, as if she is trying to reinstate Alex and deny my existence.
Oh, Charles, you mustn't think that. She misses him, that's all.
Mm, I suppose so. Who's the other one from?
It's, for a girl I worked with once.
It's
Carol.
Not bad news, is it?
No, not bad.
Shoving it in your pocket like that, I thought maybe...
No, she's just catching up on gossip. I'll read it at the office.
Not another of your lame ducks, I hope.
Lame ducks?
Looking for a shoulder to cry on. They seem to seek you out.
Oh. No. Not Carol. I'd better be going.
Leave the breakfast things. I'll see to them.
Thanks. Charles. Shall we get a tree?
What?
A Christmas tree. To mark our first Christmas together.
Oh, of course. Of course we must.
It's not too silly, is it? Just the two of us.
No, Laura, it's not silly at all. Just the two of us.
A second card with a second message. Do not forget my love, it said. Nor let this become the last of all our Christmases. The last of all our Christmases.
Laura? Laura?
Hmm? What is it?
Are you all right?
Oh, yes, I'm sorry. I was thinking about something else.
You don't look too good. Can I get you something?
No, thank you, Richard. It's kind of you.
I don't want to interfere.
Richard. Do you remember giving me a lift home?
Of course
I did. And seeing me in because I thought someone was watching the house?
Yes.
I think I know who it is.
Are you sure?
Almost. Would you shut the door?
Yes.
I think it's Frank.
Frank?
Blackwell. He worked here 2 years ago.
Yes, I remember Frank Blackwell. He took a posting overseas.
To the Far East,
That's right, Hong Kong. People said...
What? People said what?
That he got mixed up. Look, Laura, this is nothing to do with me. I really think I...
Please, Richard. It's worrying me.
Well, you know I'll do what I can. If it helps to listen...
Oh, it does. I was the reason for Frank's going. Did you know that?
Oh, not really. No one said anything to me.
It was 2 years ago. Shortly after Alex, my first husband, died... Frank and I worked closely together, so naturally he was around when I most needed support. Well, one Christmas Eve, when everything seemed bleak, he came round to my flat and... Well, the Far East posting was his idea, poor boy. To give us time to be sure of ourselves, he said, when he returned we would become engaged and eventually marry. But as time passed, I felt as if I was coming out of a tunnel, a different person. And by then, of course, there was Charles.
So you called it all off?
Well, no, that's the trouble. I couldn't bring myself to tell Frank.
But surely he found out.
I don't think so. My letters to him became more and more infrequent. I was just hoping things would sort themselves out.
And they didn't.
I didn't even tell him about Charles. And now he's back. Oh, Richard, what am I going to do?
Do you know it's him? Outside the house,
I think it must be. I can't see his face or anything. He's just there, watching. But he's written to me.
What, at the office?
No, at home. There was an unsigned card of the exact place where we used to meet for lunch.
The embankment?
How do you know I...
Oh, you often take your lunch there. I've noticed.
Unfortunately, it's also where I first met Charles.
Does he know you've had these messages?
Charles? I don't think so. He was rather thrown when he saw the picture, but he doesn't know about Frank, thank God. And yesterday's, I slipped into my pocket, said it was from an old girlfriend.
But if it is Frank watching the house...
Yes.
Well, he's bound to find out about Charles.
Yes. That's what I'm frightened of. Charles and Frank. They were so different outwardly, but they had a certain vulnerability in common. Vulnerability. And jealousy.
This is getting out of hand.
Oh, what is it?
Christmas cards. They are turning up from people I didn't even know we knew.
Oh? Like who?
Oh, who indeed? We have got another embankment card, or to be more precise, you have.
Where? Let me see.
From the same source, I assume.
Carol?
Oh, Carol. The one who used to be at the office.
Yes. Didn't I tell you?
You didn't say it was her.
I meant to. She phoned the other day.
Really?
Yes. She told me she'd sent the first card, you see, but forgot to sign it.
Oh, so she's written again 3 times in all and phoned. It's very odd of her, don't you think?
Just like her, though. I don't hear from her for years
Look.
And years, and then she...
Same scene. She hasn't got much imagination, has she?
No, I suppose not. What's she saying?
Well, how would I know? I mean, you don't think I read your cards, do you, Laura?
Of course not.
Oh, that seems to be what you're implying.
I'm sorry. I just thought that as you'd opened it...
I opened it by mistake. I am entitled to make the odd mistake, aren't I?
Charles, what's the matter with you?
Nothing. Why? Should there be anything the matter?
Well, I don't know,
And
but...
what does your friend Carol have to say for herself, or is it perhaps private?
She says, my darling Laura...
Oh, how very florid. Perhaps you better not read any more.
Yes, Charles, I think I ought to. Remember Christmas Eve. If the past means anything at all, we must meet.
Really? Oh, I wonder what she means by that.
I don't know. Old times, we were very close.
Well, obviously, and she signs herself...
Since you must have read it, you'll know it's signed F.
F for Carol!
Carol Francis. She always signed herself F. Charles, I think this has gone on long enough, don't you?
Meaning?
You're getting yourself into a state...
Yes, but what do you expect, Laura? I mean, what am I supposed to think? Three cards, the three that I know about, anyway. Two, at least, of the embankment where we used
to
meet.
But I explained about...
I add to that the fact that you have been decidedly edgy over the last
Charles,
few days.
Charles, I'm not used to this.
And the smell that greeted me when I got home the other day.
Smell?
Pipe smell. Oh. It was very noticeable in the hall. Carol smoke a pipe, does she? Well, does she?
Oh, Charles. Charles, you're muddling things up again. Now, look, come and sit down.
I don't want to sit down.
You do. Come on. Come on, darling. That's it. Now, look. Are you really so afraid that I don't love you?
I told you I don't know what to think.
Oh, my poor boy, my poor, poor boy. There's no one else.
Isn't there, Laura? I couldn't bear to lose you. You know that I couldn't let you go ever.
Would you like to meet Carol? Would that set your mind at rest?
I don't know.
I want to look after you. That's all I want.
I can't help this, Laura. I am so afraid.
Afraid? Of what?
That you will despise me.
Why should I do that?
Because I do nothing. I don't work. I can't get a job. Nobody will have me. And I cry. I bloody cry all the time.
Oh, darling. Shh. Shh. It doesn't matter.
Sometimes I don't know why you married me. I'm not even a proper husband to you these days.
Really doesn't matter. I understand.
Am I going mad imagining all sorts of horrors?
No, of course you're not.
But the tobacco smell...
Why didn't you mention it before if it worried you?
Well, I wanted to, but I couldn't.
It was only Richard. That's all.
Richard? I'm sorry, who is Richard?
Richard, from the office. He gave me a lift home.
Oh, Richard the rabbit.
Oh, you mustn't call him that. It's unkind. He's not a rabbit. He's just very shy.
What did he want?
He didn't want anything. He gave me a lift because I'd been working late. Didn't I tell you?
No, you didn't.
You can't be jealous of poor old Richard. You really can't. But, Charles, if someone did try to...
What?
If I were in danger... Real danger. You would be strong, wouldn't you?
Yes, I would do anything, anything to protect you.
And all the time that figure was waiting outside in the muffled snow, signalling his insistence through neat, relentless messages. On the following day, a fourth turned up. The final message. 23rd of December. One more day to death.
Laura, Mr. Bannister says he'd like these done by lunch.
What?
These papers, as it's Christmas Eve.
Oh, yes. Yes, leave them there, will you, Richard?
Laura. Laura, forgive me, but things are no better, are they?
No, I'm afraid they aren't.
Have you seen him again? Frank, I mean?
Yes, I think so.
But are you sure it's him? After all, you haven't actually seen...
Who else would it be?
I don't know. I just thought... Sorry.
How many people do you think I know who'd haunt me like this?
I didn't mean... I was just trying to help. If you could just do those papers.
Oh, I'm sorry, Richard. I'm so tired. Forgive me.
If there's anything I can do...
I don't know what anyone...
I could see Frank, if you like, to talk to him.
You? But what would you say?
I don't know. Be fairly straight about things,
oh,
I suppose.
Richard, you'd be out of your depth.
Oh, I see. Not really understanding. I mean, no experience of that kind of
That's
thing.
That's not what
you
I
know,
meant.
For a moment, Laura, you sounded like my sister.
I'm sorry.
She always assumes I'm not capable. Just dismisses all my suggestions.
Of course you're capable. But it's my fault for not explaining things to Frank as soon as Charles came on the scene. I have to face up to it.
Face up to it? How can you...
I don't know. Go out and confront him. Talk to him.
No, you can't do that.
I have to. I can't just leave things any longer.
Has he written again? Laura, has there been another message?
I'm going home, Richard.
No, wait. You know Frank will be there, don't you?
I've got to sort it all out.
But can't you see? It could be dangerous.
I have to go, Richard.
Leave the curtain. Please close the curtain again, Laura. The light's rather harsh. It's the snow, you see? It seems to flood the room.
Charles, what are you doing here?
Waiting.
But you said you wouldn't be in till 5. What are you waiting for?
For you, Laura. I have been waiting for you to come home. Will you come and sit by me, please?
What's the matter with you? You look awful.
You've always been my strength, my darling, haven't you?
You haven't been sitting here brooding over these silly things
silly,
in the dark.
I don't think they're silly, and I'm sure you don't either, not really. You shouldn't have kept the cards, Laura.
Cards? What do you mean?
Frank's cards. You should have destroyed them. Do not forget, my love, nor let this become the last of all our Christmases.
You found them.
Well, it wasn't difficult. I'm not completely incompetent.
You must let me explain, Charles.
Not that you signed them, but that is the name, isn't it?
It was a long, long time ago, before I knew you.
But he came back, didn't he? He's been hanging around outside our house. I expect you've seen him. Talk to him.
It's you I love, Charles. You must believe
that. And now, this card. 23rd December. One day to death. Which is today, Laura. Do you think I'd trot off to the library with that going through my head? Or do you really think that I am that spine?
He can't have meant anything.
Oh, I know what he meant. I have been sitting here all morning thinking about it. What to do? What to do? And then, well, I didn't have to think about it anymore because he came to the door.
Oh, God.
Oh, well, don't sound so surprised. He was bound to come at some point today. After all, today was the day, wasn't it? He said so himself. 23rd December, one day to death.
I don't know.
To our... door, Laura, asking about you, shouting like an idiot and pushing from room to room. We are supposed to meet, he shouted. Where is she? She said we'd meet, did you?
Of course not!
Oh, no, well, he seemed so sure of himself, full of purpose, and that's what I couldn't stand. His certainty barging into our kitchen as if I didn't exist, standing over our table where you and I have breakfast, the breakfast thing's still there. The patterns of crumbs you always make with your fingers. The coffee cups, yours, still full, grey and untouched from this morning. The breadboard. And the knife. This knife. Oh, I was strong, Laura. I was so strong when there was no strength to depend on but my own. Look, bruised my knuckles, you see?
and he crashed through the door into the garden with the force of it, breaking the glass, which shocked me, the noise and the blood on the snow. But mostly the whiteness of the snow. That's surprising, isn't it? The snow rather than the blood.
What are you going to do?
I couldn't do anything else, Laura, could I? Be weak or strong, I had to be strong.
Yes. You had to be strong.
That's what you made me. Come here.
No.
Come here, Laura. It was for your sake, too. I wanted to be strong for you.
My poor boy.
Don't call me that. Not anymore.
Softly the room became dark around us. We lay in silence for some while. Then I turned my head carefully to look at him, to concentrate on him, attend only to Charles now for my life's sake, and try as hard as I could to blot from my mind the sight of Frank's mutilated body.
You're all right.
Oh, yes.
Shall I tell you something?
What is it?
Whenever I close my eyes, I see the knife against the snow.
No, Charles.
But sometimes it looks different. The knife against pale skin.
You mean me?
Yes. But it's inevitable, isn't it?
What is
it? In death, we would be united. No one could come between us then.
No.
Of course, Laura, you... and then me. There is no other way.
Charles, are you ashamed of what you've done?
No.
You showed strength.
Yes.
Then you mustn't spoil it now.
Spoil it?
Yes. By behaving as if it were shameful. Are you ashamed of what you've done? What you did for us?
I don't know.
Charles, don't show me now that you're a coward after all. That you're still weak.
I am not Laura. I am not...
But you would be. Killing me, killing us, would be running away.
Running away?
No. Haven't you done enough running away in your life?
You're right, as always. I won't run away. I can face anyone now.
We can. You and me.
Yes. When they come, you'll be with me. Laura, and you'll wait for me, won't you?
Of course, my darling. Of course I will.
What? Oh, no.
It's all right. It's all right. It's all right. Poor, poor boy. You can face them, can't you? Yes. No. Give me the knife. Richard.
I'm sorry, Laura. I've been worried sick since you left.
Will you help me, Richard? Please.
Laura. Knife.
I need you to help me, please. Charles is... waiting upstairs, and Frank... Frank! The last I saw of Charles was when they led him out of the house that night. I watched from the window as a policeman held his elbow and they disappeared in a swirl of snow. My husband's face, but a different person behind it. Richard found me a room with his sister for the night. I couldn't return to the house until things had settled and Christmas was over.
Here, last ones from this wall, I think.
It's always such a bleak little task, isn't it?
The Christmas cards?
Mm.
Yes, I suppose so. It seems such a shame when they all have to be thrown away.
Oh, and these, please.
But they're all the same. The embankment. They must be...
Yes, they are.
What do you want to do with them?
I think I'd like you to get rid of them for me.
Get rid of them?
Will you do that for me?
Yes, if you like.
I'd like it if you put them on the fire for me, Richard.
Me?
You don't mind, do you?
No, I don't mind.
I'll explain one day. Perhaps.
Well, here goes.
Thank you.
And
now, I think you ought to go.
Yes, I suppose I ought, but...
Yes?
You'll be all right, will you?
Why shouldn't I be?
I was wondering...
What?
The house, seeming so empty and everything. Perhaps I could call round again sometime? If that would help.
Help me?
Yes. And me, I suppose.
Of course, Richard. It will be nice to see you again. I enjoyed getting Richard to burn the cards. He was so obedient. And it implicated him. Still, it was a shame to see all my careful work go up in flames. Of course, the first card was genuine. That's how I knew poor Frank was back. But he would never have had the spirit to write the others. Poor boy. No, that was all my work. Like the calls I made to him, begging his help, asking him to watch over me, urging him to come to the house on Christmas Eve. See, I've always liked bringing people together. I couldn't resist going home to discover the result of my little plot. Charles and Frank. Which was nearly my undoing. Charles's reaction being rather stronger than I'd calculated. Frightening. But thrilling, too, in a way. I could almost have kept him after that. Almost. But now there's dear Richard. Such a poor, timid boy. And it will be nice, too, to see him again. For a while, anyway.
At this point, the diary ends. There's no further entry. It was found in a box in Laura's house shortly after she'd sold up and moved away. No one has heard of her or Richard since. Could it be that poor Richard has met the same fate as all the others, and that Laura is starting another diary somewhere? We can only draw our own conclusions, and be very careful when trusting those who often seem the most trustworthy. I do trust, however, that you enjoyed the performances by Maureen O'Brien as the evil Laura, Mick Ford as Charles, and Andrew Branch as Richard. It was Nick Warburton who wrote his last card, and Martin Jenkins who directed it. I am Edward De Souza, your man in black, inviting you to join me next week when we shall travel deeper than ever into the unknown.